Okay, so here we are. It is, as of the recording of this video, April 19th, 2024. We are the day before Record Store Day 2024, which for me anyway, is not something that really gets excited for me until like right now, until I start actually seeing these records, until I actually start like getting involved with these albums or really looking up these things or seeing other people's reviews. I want to get this video out for you today so that you can see a preview of this because it gets me excited about this stuff. It gets you guys excited and we get to kind of see the actual real products here. So I actually got to go out to Hop Fidelity in Westchester, Pennsylvania, which is literally the closest record store to my house. I went and Googled it to find out what the closest record store is because I actually have a lot of things going on this weekend. Specifically with my family. So Record Store Day is only a very small part of my weekend this weekend, but I still want it to be a very big part of the channel here and want to share lots of things with you guys. Plus, this record store is really cool. Not only do they serve beer, which is totally awesome, and snacks like cool different popcorns and things like that, but the owner of the place, Byron, is really, really awesome. So I haven't actually been here for a while. I don't actually get out to record stores enough as much as I should, which is a wonderful thing about Record Store Day. It gets more of us out to record stores. But as soon as I walked into the store, Byron immediately remembered me from last year, and he clued me in to two records last year that I totally did not even know about for Record Store Day. This Black Renaissance, which I wasn't even aware of last year, and apparently this was a pretty hot one out, and I believe this came out from Love and Hate Records, and it is a really, really awesome record, and it was really hard to find back in the day. It's kind of like black spiritual jazz, and it's really awesome. I mean, just a very good record, and I was glad that I was able to pick it up. I didn't even know about it, and then he was like, what kind of stuff are you into, man? And as soon as I said, like, you know, I like soul and jazz and funk and stuff like that, he's like, oh, did you hear about this one? And he said that it went off the shelves pretty quickly, but I went out and got it immediately, and I was very thankful that I did. The other one that he clued me onto was this one, Flash and the Dynamics. Now, last year, I started getting onto a big Latin soul kick and stuff like that, and this record is immediately into that vein. I'm also getting a lot more of these Kraft Latin reissues very soon, so definitely stay tuned for a video about that. This is on this ridiculously awesome purple vinyl on Tico Records. Again, I had never even heard either of those records, and I had never even met Byron before, and he immediately kind of knew right what I was looking for as soon as I walked in. So that's a great sign of a great owner, which is why I wanted to come to the store again this year and actually go through the line and get out there at like 6 o'clock in the morning and wait for everybody and stuff like that. So there will be a video coming for that. I hope that that video comes on Sunday after Record Store Day, but I make no promises. It'll probably be out on Monday. And if you subscribe to the channel and you hit the notification bell, you'll be notified as soon as the video goes. So you'll be able to watch it as soon as it comes out. So I went to Hop Fidelity on Thursday night to do this little preview because I wanted to see the actual stock that's gonna be in for Record Store Day. And this was really cool because he usually closes the shop at 7 p.m. during the weekdays, and he actually stayed open from 8 until midnight because Thursday at midnight, the Pearl Jam was dropping and the Taylor Swift was dropping. So he had both of those in the shop, so he had all kinds of people coming in. You could come in and put your name on the list and then come back at midnight, so you didn't have to sit in the shop all night, but you could sit in the shop and hang out, and there were plenty of people that were doing that, and it was very cool. Everybody was very excited about Record Store Day, so he gave me a very quick rundown of a bunch of the records that, you know, he's excited about and that I'm excited about and that some of the other people in the store were excited about. So let's go through that here and we'll catch up with Byron at Hop Fidelity Records.
So my name is Byron, Greater X. I'm the owner of Hop Fidelity. And we're going through the Record Store Day stuff.
Nice. Yeah. But tonight we are here because you have a little special going on for the Pearl Jam and the Taylor Swift, right?
Yeah, we're doing a midnight sale. So you come out tonight, you can get the new Pearl Jam and the new Taylor at midnight. So I haven't done anything like this before, so we'll see how it goes. We also serve beer, so it's not a bad place to hang out. if you have to for a little while.
Yeah, right.
We're gonna go over some of your record store day picks that you suggest, and specifically for the soul lovers or for the soul jazz lovers, at least we'll start with those, and then we'll get into like the other real popular ones. But these are some sleeper ones here that you got going on.
So you're gonna see these at a lot of stores. They're Japanese imports. I got them through one particular distro that brings in a good amount of that sort of stuff. This record, I mean, does it for me in a lot of different ways. It's obscure. I have no idea who this artist is. I'd never listened to it before until it was on the list. And it's a Japanese pressing. It's got an OB. I think this originally came out in like 19...
That's all you need.
I love that stuff. I think it originally came out in 74.
Okay.
So, you know, but it very easily not a record you would ever encounter, you know, in America, I wouldn't think. Same distro, there are three other Bill Evans. I mean, everybody knows this one, but we've got copies of Consecration 1, Consecration 2, and Consecration Immortal. And these are reissues, I believe, again, but just not records you see, you know, and everybody's big into Bill Evans right now, so, or have been for a long time. So his stuff generally does really, really well on record store day. I mean, there's a lot of cool stuff.
Yeah,
there's always a lot of great jazz.
What do you think is gonna be, I saw that today, actually.
I mean,
was thinking about that one.
It's one of those things where it's like, I don't really remember what the soundtrack sounds like. But it's Airplane, you know, so it's gotta be good. So it doesn't say that it comes with the rolling paper, so I don't know if it does. It's on Smoke and Green vinyl. However, the Amboy Dukes comes with a pack of rolling papers. So this is actually a really good record. I mean, yeah, so this was Ted Nugent's band before he had a solo career. So, you know, people have opinions about that guy, rightfully so, but the Amboy Dukes were... They were a really good psych band, and their records, they're around, but you don't see them that often. I didn't get nearly as many copies of this as I would have liked, but a reissue of this.
What is that? It's on gold vinyl? Yeah,
yep,
gold.
It is gold.
Gold
yep.
color vinyl. Nice. I actually don't have that.
I think I have a copy from a long time ago. This, I mean, with Stranger Things, of course, Kate Bush is all the rage now. So I don't know if it's one side is a picture and then the other side is just straight vinyl. I didn't take them out of the plastic to check, but it's like an EP. So what else we got? This is Flaming Lips and some others. And the Reading Rainbow theme song. It's all about this project to get kids reading, but it's a Flaming Lips, so it'll probably be really cool.
Yeah,
like I said, I still got more to bring in. The Cranberries.
You had how many boxes left?
Like four boxes I gotta bring in, yeah. Here's one that everybody's gonna be bonkers about, is, you know, the Noah Kahan. He's red hot. He's a singer-songwriter from Vermont. I just became familiar with him literally like Black Friday, because he put an EP out that everybody was going nuts for. And I wasn't aware of him before that, and I moved here from Vermont, oddly enough. So it's great stuff. If you're into, you know, kind of rural singer-songwriter stuff, it's well-produced, so it's not rustic at all, but it's good stuff.
This is
There's
a
also
cool
a 7-inch.
The Punk 45 series are really good.
Yeah, so we got all the soul jazz comps.
Yes, I'm interested in that Rude Boy.
Yeah, the Jazz Dispensary always is very popular. They did a different version of Cracker Island with some, I think some bonus stuff on it. Jerry Garcia Band, of course. That they only did 3,000 of this year. I ordered a bunch of these. I only got four, unless more are coming. So that's gonna go really quick. Yeah, well, with only 3,000, you know, they got to spread them around as best they can, I guess, as Yusuf Lateef.
The Yusuf Lateef lullaby?
Yep. This is interesting. This is on...
That's the green.
Oh, that's my... No, this is black.
That's the black. There's a green.
Oh, there's a glow in the dark.
I
was going to say, okay. Another Japanese Hobie. Lost in Translation soundtrack. Okay. That's been out before.
These are a lot of ones I haven't seen. You got some awesome ones that I got on the list, man.
This another through that same distro. This guy is a Polish jazz guy. The Wotan Mazaluski Quintet. And I had a customer specifically ask for me to try to get him these. So there's two of them. We'll see if anybody else buys them. I got a couple copies of each. My guy's going to be happy, but I don't know if anybody else knows who he is. Two Meat Puppets releases this year. The box set and Live in Montana, which is cool. Sonny Rollins. We got Linda Ronstadt.
That Sonny Rollins is calling my name.
Dwight Yoakam. So it's a reprise years.
Yeah.
Yep. Oh, what did I say? I said it's Meat Puppets. Never
mind. That's right. Okay, right now we got The Grateful Dead.
The Grateful Dead, of course. Wilco, The Whole Love, Linda Ronstadt. This one, I mean, it's all his solo albums. So if you're a television fan, like, this is a kind of a must-have. I just had an original of Marquee Moon in here. In the shrink wrap. I have a rule where I don't get high on my own supply, and I stick to it, because if I don't, it'll get crazy. But that record was so hard to not keep, because it was perfect, and you don't see the record a lot to begin with, but to see it like in that condition in the shrink wrap still was something else. He's a great guitar player. He's one of those kind of guys. He has a certain guitar sound and style that you'll like. Once you listen to him, it becomes easy to pick out like a Verlaine song or somebody that is obviously been influenced by Tom Verlaine, because it's a very, I don't want to say unique, but it's different. Yeah. This is a Ramones demos, Sire demos.
Yeah, I saw that one the other day too.
So that one I'm sure people will be into. Replacements, live in 1986. There really is. It's probably a pretty cool rockabilly comp. I mean, it's...
My dad would probably love that. Yeah, my dad would totally love this.
I guess the... this is the demo tape recordings for the Rocky Horror Show. Yeah, so this would have been the play, not the movie soundtrack. So, I mean, probably very similar, but different sounding. Stones, of course. Nice. Live at Racket. I forget when that show was. This is cool. This is good. This one was numbered. Blue Black Swirled Vinyl. So if you're an early Stones fan, it'll be a nice collectible. We get the Pauly Shore and the Crusties. This was supposed to come out for Black Friday, and it got delayed. So they finally got it pressed. Okay. I had a bunch of people back then asking me about it, so I definitely wanted to bring it in. And I don't know, maybe it's good, you know?
Which one? Yeah, probably. Oh, I saw the Sonic Youth in there too.
Yep, Susie and the Banshees, Spawn soundtrack. Yep. Soft. So I only got one of these because I don't sell a lot of their stuff. They were the guys that did Tainted Love.
Oh, right.
That was their big song. But yeah, great. If you're into like that 80s kind of new wave, they're fantastic. But that one particular song pretty much just ended up on like a 12-inch EP, and everybody buys that. But their other albums, kind of, I've got them hanging out. There's nobody buys them. This, I didn't get nearly as many of these as I wanted to. But that's going to go pretty quick. Yeah. So
it's an exclusive limited numbered edition too.
Right. Yeah. So they'll probably keep it going, but this is the numbered one.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. They're doing more and more of that with Record Store Day, where it's like you get an exclusive color or a numbered copy for Record Store Day, and then they'll just keep making the things as time goes on.
I was wondering what they're going to
do with this Bill Evans mono, if they're going to do this mono for Record Store Day and then like a stereo release later or something.
Yeah.
They'll probably do that.
These guys are great. Nobody really pays attention to this band, Sparks. They were much bigger like over in Europe, even though they're from LA. But they were active like in the late 70s and through the 80s. And they're really great. Their records are hard to find. But yeah, I don't know if anybody's gonna know about that. Got Joe Strummer. I only got two of these. Yeah, from the Clash. So hopefully I got enough for the folks that really want one. More soul jazz comps, Sun Ra.
Yeah, everybody's gonna be looking for that.
Yeah, another Sun Ra.
What are ones, or what's one, like, so last year, that Macho Man one was like a big sleeper.
Right, yeah.
That ended up being one that everybody ended up going after. What's one this year that you think is gonna be a good sleeper?
It's hard to say. John, you got an opinion on that?
It's the best album, but after they broke up, the half the band went on to form Mars Volta.
Oh, okay.
And the other half formed Sparta. But this is an amazing album.
Interesting.
It's been so hard to find. And no one's been talking about it, but I think people,
right,
like that the day of, are going to be like, oh, right, I didn't know this was out.
This is here, and yeah.
Kind of, I'm hoping it doesn't because I want a copy. Right. Cool, because like at the drive-in, like you hear them, and then when they broke up and Sparta and Mars Volta formed, the sound split in two. So like if you put the Mars Volta and Sparta together, you get at the drive-ins.
It's like super underground, but this one will go pretty quick. It's Dave Grohl, Charlie Benante, and Scott Ian. So two guys from Anthrax, and then Dave Grohl.
And it's just 45?
It's just a 45 right now. Yeah, I mean, maybe they'll put out like a full length at some point. This, I think, is going to be really cool. This is another one. It's Music on Vinyl that did this.
Oh.
So the Timeless label. Yeah. So it's just a comp of. I think it is Giles. Yeah. If I'm thinking his favorite tracks from the label. So I think like those Bill Evans records originally might have come out on Timeless. But yeah. So this one was one that I really. They only did 750 copies of this. Some of these, like, I don't know if they're, like, they must be official U.S. ones because they have the Record Store Day logo on them, or they might just be European Record Store Day issues that...
Because there are different releases for European Record
Store
Day.
There are, yeah. I think there's a Record Store Day Japan, there's, like, a Record Store Day UK. There might be one just for, like, mainland Europe. I'm not sure 100%. But so there are, and each get different things. And then sometimes... Some of the distros get some of the other releases somehow. They have connections or deals or whatever. But usually they don't end up, like if you're just dealing with a one-stop, like Alliance or AMS or something like that, those guys a lot of times don't have these releases. They're more for these smaller independent distros that deal with those labels. Like, you know, URP brings in a ton of music on vinyl, but they're a big label. They reissue everything from Alice in Chains to Miles Davis.
Yeah.
Yeah, and they do really nice pressings.
Yeah, I just listened to it actually for the first time in quite a while.
All right.
So yeah, dude, any side of that's pretty sweet.
Let's
put it on. Little honor to Dickie, so there you go. Here, I'll leave my bag over here right now. Just hopefully fill that up later.
So you're checking out for this, you're looking for the Talking Heads?
Yeah, absolutely.
Which,
yeah.
What record is it?
It's a live show in Toronto, right? Or something, is it? What is it? It's a live. There you go, right there it is.
There it is.
Oh, that's right, at a radio station. Yeah, it was like a performance for a radio station.
Oh, very cool.
I got they did the, like the first time that they're putting that out. So
I got a few more.
Yeah, I'm excited. If I get up early enough, I think that's
right.
that's
the big thing, right? Yeah.
You gotta get up, man.
Exactly.
I'll be here.
Exactly.
So.
Very excited.
Very cool.
I'm saying that's Noah.
Cool, so I'll get here at 6 in the morning. I was planning to come around at 6:45, 7, just chilling outside talking to people.
Oh, yeah.
Saying that's Noah.
That's Noah.
Cool, so I'll get here at 6 in the morning.
Right.
So what are you looking for this Saturday?
So we're absolutely coming in here.
Yeah, you're coming in here for this Noah.
Absolutely. So we have every Noah album, but I Am. So we just last past week picked up his new pressing, Stick Season, and that comes with a third LP with extra tracks than the original Stick Season that we got last year. So. We just got to complete his collection here. We saw him live in Ocean City, Maryland back in October. Great live, great on vinyl. So hopefully we can get one of these 15 vinyls here.
Right.
Not too worried about it, but you know.
Yeah. I didn't actually ask him if he has that Penrose showcase.
Oh, that Penrose?
Nice.
There single
it is.
One. And I know
there's only one.
She had her eye on it, but it's the one that's probably the back of our list. So if we get in here, we get Noah, we grab one or two other things, then that's probably the one we'll leave behind.
She's a fan of Penrose.
She just listened to the first one and liked the vibe of it. So I think it's just something that she looked through the catalog and then started listening to a couple different things that she didn't know. And
what time did you get out here last year?
Last year, I want to say we probably pulled up right around 7 a.m. and there's probably 15 to 20 people in line. So we're like that third wave that got in. I came straight back here knowing that Noah was right here. And I flipped through this whole thing once and I was like, they're all gone, man. And I looked through one more time and then all of a sudden, there it was. There was one copy left. Pulled it out. Okay, all right. Got what I needed.
That's awesome.
Let me grab the doors out. Very cool. Checked out, had a beer, and then relaxed.
At 8 in the morning, right?
At 8 in the morning, of course.
That'll be great.
Hey, free beer.
Yes, I can't wait to. Yeah, I can't wait to do that. That'll be awesome.
Yeah, so.
Somebody was telling me about all these reissues that they're doing.
It's got 5 bonus tracks on it, so that's
very exciting.
It is. And this, like, I don't think this record's been, like, reissued recently.
No,
I have not seen copies of it anywhere. It's French psychedelic music from the late 60s, early 70s. So, yeah.
Great selection.
Yeah. So this one should be a lot of fun.
I will tell you this, that Japanese soul jazz record is 100% on the top of my list at this point. It has surpassed anything else on my list, and I was so, so thankful to Byron for making that suggestion to me as soon as we came into the store. And it was great. Again, like he immediately saw me and was like, ah, I made these suggestions for you last year. Check out these ones from this year. Also, while I was in the shop that night, of course, I couldn't help myself and buy some records, so I bought some records. I did not stay until midnight to get the Pearl Jam or the Taylor Swift, but I might get the Pearl Jam at another point. And it was cool. He had the Philadelphia or the Northeast region variant. Apparently, there's not different city variants. I thought they were doing the whole Rolling Stones things with like 57 different variants. Apparently, there's like 5 different variants of that Pearl Jam, and he's got the Philadelphia region variant, and Mike from the In-Groove has the Arizona region variant. So definitely get whatever region you are in, or get the black version if that's what you like. But I got some records from Hot Fidelity because he had some awesome ones on the shelves here. So I'm gonna show those to you. None of these are Record Store Day releases or anything like that, but one of them is one that I'm very excited about that is part of some of the artists that I'll be getting on Record Store Day. So as soon as I saw this on the shelf, I had to pick it up. This is Trio 64 from Bill Evans, and this is the Analog Productions Verve, you know, reissue series that they're doing. This was a great deal on this. I got it for $30. I think normally this is usually like a $38 or $40 record, and this is listed on the In-Groove, Mike from the In-Groove's top 100 analog records of all times, and I've been obsessed with that list lately of like wanting to get like all those records, so this is one of the ones that I wanted to add to this. Plus, I've, you know, been going down the Bill Evans rabbit hole, as we all have, and we're all very excited about the Bill Evans, including those 3 other Bill Evans records that I wasn't even aware of, the Consecration 1, Consecration 2, and Consecration Immortal. I might end up getting all 3 of those on Record Store Day. We'll see about that. But this was one that I was very excited about. Might as well show off the record store bag. I hardly ever go to a record store these days, so I hardly ever get the bag to show off. So show the record store bag. It's just a bag. Love this one. This is the next one that I got, which is also a Verve reissue from Acoustic Sounds that I was able to pick up at a great price at Hot Fidelity, which is totally awesome. And this is Nina Simone's Pastel Blues. And if you watch the channel, I just did a Vinyl Me Please video on a bunch of Nina Simone records. I did not have a bunch of her stuff, but now I have like 5 albums of hers and she's just fantastic. So I had to get this one, which is very awesome. And again, Acoustic Sounds, and it's got the, you know, Acoustic Sounds hype sticker on it and all that good jazz. So Very excited about this one and couldn't pass this one up. And finally, the last one that I picked up, I actually wasn't gonna pick this one up, but I walked by it like 10 times in the store and I had to get it because I have the Vanguard box set from Vinyl Me Please, and I'm gonna talk about that in a future video. But I wanted to get this because it was only $15 for a VG Plus 1967 version of this, and it's the original, so I get to now compare an original copy of this to the Vanguard reissue that I have in that box set. So I'm very excited about that. Plus, the Vanguard box set that I got actually had a scratched record on it, so I had to get a different record of that Joan Baez, and that one also had a scratch on a different side, so hopefully this one won't have a scratch and I'll actually have a version of this that doesn't have any scratches on it. So again, thank you very much to Byron for letting us into Hot Fidelity to get this awesome behind the scenes video and to get our hands on the stock and to show off some of these records. Hopefully you guys are excited about Record Store Day as much as I am. I will be at Hot Fidelity at 7 o'clock in the morning. We're gonna film a bunch of stuff there. Like I said, I hope to get the video out on Sunday, but if I don't get the video out on Sunday, it'll definitely go out on Monday. So make sure you subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell, so as soon as the video comes out, you'll be notified about it so you can see it right away. If you wanna see what I did last year at Record Store Day, you can check out that video right here. I also visited Hot Fidelity last year as well, and another awesome place called Shady Dog Records. So I will see you guys on the next one.